was talking to my mom today about the trip we took to Australia. For those of you that don't know, my family, me, and Andre went to Australia around Christmas time. We love Christmas Day, went there for New Year's. We went there for about a week, and it was really, really fun. But there were some things that happened there that I need to make a video. I just wanted to tell you a couple stories of things that happened on the trip that just watch this video. Okay, so when we first got there, we were staying in this little cabin about a 2-hour drive outside of Sydney. So it was out of the city, kind of in the countryside, I guess you would call it. We were there for about 4 days. The second or third day, Andre and I woke up early. We were gonna go for a walk. So we get outside of the cabin and I look up, and on the ceiling part of the roof, right outside the window to the room that I was sleeping in, there are these two huntsman spiders. For those of you that don't know what huntsman spiders are, this is what they are, and they can grow to the size of a dinner plate. But we notice these, I start freaking out. I'm like, okay, these spiders are gonna eat me in my sleep if we don't do something about it. Like, they're right outside the room. They're gonna come inside and I am going to die. We need to get rid of them. My mom calls the guy that ran the cabin thing, and he comes over a couple hours later. And I'm here thinking, okay, he's gonna like burn them or crush them or do something with them. He asked for a plastic cup. Okay, I'll get you a plastic cup. You're gonna take them away, right? So I give them this cup. He puts the cup up to the spiders and just kind of scoops them into the cup and then starts shaking them in the cup so that they don't bite his hand. Is he really doing this right now? And he just takes the spiders and throws it on the grass a few meters away from the cabin. All right, well, it looks like I won't be walking on the grass for the rest of the trip. But at least they were off the cabin, whatever. I just tried not to think about it. The next day, we get in the car, we're going to the zoo. My sister, myself, and Andre are in the back seat, and my mom and my brother are in the front seat. So we're just driving along, and my sister has her head like rested against the window, and then all of a sudden, she screams. My mom like freaks out. We're like, oh my gosh, what? She's like, there was a spider on the window. And we're all like, no, there's not. Like, spiders can't stay on the window. We were driving pretty fast. It was probably just a leaf, whatever, relax. A few minutes later, we're driving along and I see this shadow going across the car. So it would have been on the back windshield. I thought it was a bird or something. 10 seconds later, I look over to Andre. On the window is this massive huntsman spider, and he just sprints across the window and I start screaming, my sister's screaming, and the spider runs all the way around to the front of the car, across the front windshield. So now my mom's screaming, my brother's screaming, like we're all just terrified. My brother gets out of his seat, like jumps in my mom's lap, like she's freaking out. She doesn't even want to have her feet down at the pedals because she thinks it's gonna come in the car. Then it just goes down to the bottom of the windshield and it's gone. We're in the car thinking, oh my gosh, it's gonna crawl through the vents. So my mom shuts off all the air conditioning, closes all the vents. We're just sitting in the car sweating. It is crazy hot. And we didn't want to open the windows either because it could just come in. We're just in the car, just dripping sweat. We finally get to the zoo and we drive into the parking lot and the guy is trying to get us to open the window. And my mom's like, no, you don't understand. She's in the car trying to explain to him that there is a spider the size of my face on our car right now. And then he sees it on the roof of the car and he like kind of takes a step back, and then, I'm not even kidding, he grabs the spider and just flings it off. Did he really just, what? And I'm terrified of spiders, so I could never do that in a million years. These Australian people, they just, we found out after that apparently these spiders are, I think, like the number one cause of accidents, because what they do is they will get in the car and they like kind of being between two snug places. So they will climb inside, what are those things even called? The things that you flip down in a car and they have like the mirror visor things? Are they, my mind is blank there, I'm sorry. The spiders will crawl in between those, and when people are driving and they go to put it down, they will fall into your lap. Honestly, if that happened to me, I would probably just jump out of the car. And that is a perfect introduction to the next story that I have that I need to tell you really badly because I still can't even believe it happened. The day we had to leave, so maybe a couple days later, when we were leaving, we packed the car up, put all the suitcases in the trunk, phones, cameras, everything was in the car, ready to go. We were all in the car, my brother was in the passenger seat, my sister, myself, and Andre were in the back seat, and we were just waiting for my mom. We're in the car, and the car is parked beside the cabin, and the cabin is on this hill. And the hill kind of goes down into this field, and then it keeps going down, and then it goes down off, and there's this little cliff, and it goes into the ocean. My brother's in the front seat. He's kind of like fidgeting in the front seat, and he reaches to the middle part and bumps the stick and shifts the car into neutral. And we slowly start rolling backwards. Because we're on a hill, we pick up speed really, really quickly. And he is screaming. I'm just sitting in the back like, oh my gosh, I have to do something. We're gonna go into the ocean. So I reach forward and I tried to shift the stick into park and it wouldn't change. And my brother's the only one in the front seat. He's 10, so he has no idea what he's doing. I'm in the back just freaking out like, this is it. We're gonna die. And then I just thought, I need to get to the front seat. I need to slam on the brakes. That's the only thing that's gonna stop this car. We're just going down the hill quite fast at this point. And I start climbing to the front seat. My brother's screaming. It was all a blur to me, to be honest. I just remember Andre was silent. He said nothing. So I'm climbing to the front seat and I finally get in the seat and I turn around to see what Andre's doing. He's not in the car and the car door is wide open. So we are going down the hill, the door's wide open, Andre's gone. I finally slam on the brakes and we stop. I look out my window and Andre is just lying on the grass. Over there, just... He jumped out of the car while we were rolling down the hill and he said nothing. I had no idea he even jumped out of the car and I remember thinking like, I could have just run over you. Why would you jump out of the car? And then my mom finally comes out of the house and she's like, why are you guys down there on the grass? What were you doing? And me and my brother are just in the car bawling. Like, I just started crying because it was just so scary. I explained to her what happened. And she told me that she was just in the kitchen and she like looked up and she saw the car like down the hill and she was just thinking in her head like, oh, I guess they decided to go for a drive. I just really wish I could have seen Andre jump out of the car. My sister saw it and I guess like, cause he had to clear the door, otherwise he would have got hit by the door. So he like leaped out of the car. And I remember he was like, why didn't you guys jump out of the car? My brother is in the car, he's 10. He is not about to jump out of anything. Also, we had our suitcases and everything in the car. I was not about to let my stuff go into the ocean. It all ended up being fine, but it could have ended very differently. I hope you found one or both of those stories entertaining. They're really funny now. At the time, they were both terrifying and I thought I was going to die in both situations. But they make for pretty good stories. But I hope you guys are having a good week so far and I will see you guys next time. Bye!